Hey guys, assalamualaikum. It's Jenna G. Welcome back to my channel. Today's video, we are going to be making an easy and simple mahi mahi and potato skewers. But before we get into the video, of course, you guys gotta make sure hit that subscribe button and also the bell notification button, and that's just to ensure that you don't miss out on any of my videos to come. So the mahi mahi that I have on hand here, you see how nicely parceled out and stuff it is. This was actually caught by the Ramsamuj family, and they actually generously gave it to the husband. So thanks so much for them for filleting it and for parceling it out as well. Very much appreciated. And just in case you want to see how an actual mahi mahi is caught, of course, take a look at this footage. So this mahi mahi was actually caught over 20 miles out of the north coast of our beautiful island of Trinidad. And mahi mahi is actually a highly sought after food fish, and it's known for its very firm white meat, which is not fishy at all. And that's one of the reasons why it was perfect for this recipe, using it on the skewer stick so it will not fall apart. They're actually also known as one of the fast growing and reproducing fish in the ocean, so highly targeted for commercial fishing, and it can be found in many restaurants. I know for sure almost every restaurant you go to, I guarantee there's a mahi mahi dish on the menu. And now on to our mahi mahi and potato skewers. Let's go through the ingredients. So I've got my mahi mahi, I've got some vegetables. Now if you have more vegetables, if you got like mushrooms, zucchini, or any fancies, any Brussels sprouts even, you can add them. But this is what I have right now on hand. So I'm going to be using some onion, carrot, and sweet peppers. I've got some potatoes that I washed and scrubbed properly. I'm going to be using some olive oil. And these different seasonings here, I'm going to be adding some dried thyme, some parsley, paprika, garlic powder, a little bit of jeera is going in there as well, and some all-purpose seasoning. Has salt, so we don't need to add salt. And I'm also going to be using these skewers sticks. So let's get into it. I have my water up boiling, so I'm just going to be cutting this into pieces. I'm leaving the skin on, but if you want to peel it, that's fine, all up to you. I'm just going to cut them up into chunks. You want to try to keep it as equal as possible. And now I'm just going to put them to boil a little for a little while. Now the reason for boiling them is just to ensure when we put it onto the skewer sticks that they cook around the same time as the mahi mahi. So we're just going to boil it until it's like halfway cooked through, because you don't want to boil it too much, because then it will get soft and fall off when we are trying to put it onto the sticks. So let's just pop it into the pot for a couple of minutes. I'm not adding any salt to this, and we're just going to cook it until it's halfway cooked through. Next, I am just going to prepare my vegetables. So I'm just going to slice my carrots. And you can actually cut them down the centers as well, so they are smaller pieces, up to you. Now the carrots as well, if you don't want too much of a crunch, you can also put it into the pot with the potatoes just so that it can cook through just for a little while. Mahi mahi cooks very quickly, so you don't want to overcook the fish, and you don't want to have undercooked potatoes or vegetables. The sweet peppers will cook around the same time as the mahi mahi, so there's no need to think about putting that to boil before or to steam before. And same thing goes for the onion that we are using. So we've got our vegetables prepared, and I am actually going to drop this into the pot with the potatoes just for it to soften up a little bit. And now let's prepare the mahi mahi. So all I'm going to be doing is simply cutting this into chunks, and it's a fairly firm fish as well, so you don't really have to worry too much about it falling apart. So this is what our fish pieces look like. So I dropped in the carrot pieces. Now you can just use a fork or a knife just to check to see if the potatoes are cooked. Remember, you don't want to get them too soft because it will fall apart when you put in it to the skewer. So this is fine. I'm going to take them out of the boiling water, and I'm just going to transfer it to a bowl. You can run some cold water over it to stop the cooking process. And now let's season up everything and just put together the skewers. So I'm just going to add some lime juice to my mahi mahi pieces. And next, actually, I don't have like a proper or a structured way per se to put together the skewer. So this is my fast and easy sort of lazy way, if you want to say it. Because usually what you do is just season up everything and add everything individually. Actually, what I like to do is just add everything to one bowl, add all these seasonings, and just put together your skewers. So if you have, or if you prefer extremely neat looking skewers, let's say like fish, then the sweet peppers, and then the onions in a particular order, you might want to do it separately, but I'm just going to go for putting it all in together and just build my skewers as I go along. So you want to be careful when you add in the potatoes and the carrots, as they will be hot. So you don't want your fish and your other vegetables cooked. You don't want overcooked fish. To this, I'm adding some olive oil. And then I'm going to add each one of the seasonings that I would have shown you guys just now. I'm just going to mix everything up. And now I'm going to add them to my sticks. So you can start any way you like. You can start with the potato first, then we can add fish, carrot, sweet pepper, some onions, then we can add more fish. You can just play around with it, have fun with it. And you're just going to continue doing this until you've got your skewers all ready. So that's what it looks like. I'm just going to set them aside. So they are all done and ready to put into our cast iron skillet, or you can use a grill if you don't have a cast iron pan. So I've got it all heated up, and I'm just going to add. I remember the potatoes are halfway cooked through. This will not take long at all. So you want to leave it for a couple of minutes, and usually when the halfway through the pieces of the meat or the fish, you see it cooked through, then I'm just going to flip it over. This is what the finished product looks like, guys. So we've got our potato pieces on it, our mahi mahi, onion, sweet peppers, carrots, and onions. We've got a nice combination here. Just remember, like I said, you can use any vegetable, the order. You can put it in fish first if you want, or only mahi mahi pieces. You can mix it all up however you like to mix it all up. So this is what it looks like. It smells so good and it looks so nice. Just remember, if you don't have the cast iron skillet, you can just use a grill or a regular pan if you like. Alright guys, so that is it for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed this mahi mahi and potato skewers. So I'm just going to be plating it out. I'm just going to be putting some salad and our mahi mahi skewers. So we've got some potatoes in there, some fresh salad, a little bit of the vegetables. Delicious and healthy meal. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Be sure to give it a big thumbs up if you did like it. Share with all your friends and your family. And of course, be sure to try it out. And I will see you guys in the next video.